AndEngine? I keep getting all these requests. Make AndEngine tutorials. Make game tutorials. Android games. Let's do this. You guys want to make a game? Let's make an effing game, son.
What's happening, Captain? Welcome to the second AndEngine tutorial where we're going to actually get into not developing anything yet, but setting up some more stuff for our AndEngine project, such as Box2d, which is an extension. It's a kind of a library or framework that we can use to detect collisions, to work with physics, gravity, acceleration, all that stuff that we need, and it makes our game development process a lot easier. So let's get that going first, and we're also going to talk about some errors that you guys might have had in the last tutorial. So right click again, go to import, and under this Git folder there should be a project from Git. Again, if you guys don't have the Git folder, check out the last video in this AndEngine series and it'll show you how to get this Git folder. So just select that, hit next, and then URI next. It's kind of exactly how we did the AndEngine. This time it's going to be a different URL link. I'll put this in the description, and as you can see, this is the AndEngine physics or Box2d extension. So just copy that, paste it up here. So as you can see, it doesn't set up a lot of this repository stuff. So what you can do is have it copied onto your clipboard, or just, you know, control copy here first before you do the Git, and then do your import, and it should set up everything for you. Again, projects from Git, URI, and as you can see here, it's already copied it from the clipboard, pasted it there, put the host and the repository path, then just hit next and go ahead and hit next again. And what we're going to need to do is make sure again this is the GLES2, and looks like I already have the extension, but I'm just going to put a 2 there to make it different, and hit next again. And then just throw in import existing projects, hit next, make sure that's checked, hit finish, and there we go. As you can see, we get an error. Like, some of you guys might have had this error before. Let's see what the error says. Okay, so it's not giving me the exact error that I was hoping for, but one of the errors that you guys might get is a complacency error. So to fix that, of any of these folders, you want to right click, go down to the properties tab. Whoops, missed it. Properties tab. Go into this Java compiler here, and you want to hit enable project specific settings. Go to 1.6 and hit apply. The next thing that we want to do is go in. The error that I'm getting right now, I think it's because I gave it a different name, is where is it? The Android folder here. You can see it's not linked to the AndEngine extension, so essentially it couldn't find the AndEngine library. So we're going to remove that, and then we're going to add the library that we have within our workspace. Again, the AndEngine framework or library. Go like that, add that, and hit apply, hit OK. Don't hit OK yet. Then go to the Java build path and make sure both of those are selected under the order and export. Hit OK, and we should be good to go. And again, if you got a complacency error down here in the console, just right click on it, go to properties, again, Java compiler, check that, make sure it's 1.6, and then apply it as well. So now we're all set up with Box2d, which again is the physics framework or library extension of AndEngine. So now we can do a lot of really cool stuff. The other thing I want to get set up in this tutorial is I lied to you guys about running it on the emulator. You actually can run it on the emulator. And here's kind of a spoiler alert of what we're going to be creating. This, obviously, this is very rough draft, and our game is going to be a lot sweeter than this. But it's kind of like the Java applet game that we created. There's going to be platforms that go across, and you can bounce on them and stuff like that. It's going to be a lot cooler than it looks, trust me, guys. Before we end this tutorial, I want to get your emulator set up so we can test out our AndEngine games, just in case you don't have a phone to test it on. Obviously, your phone will be a lot more fun to play our game and stuff like that. But how you do that is go into your Windows tab and go down to the AVD Manager. Grab one of the emulators that you're going to test your game on and hit Edit. Or we can create a new emulator. I'm going to call it AndEngine. Target will be 2.2, And down here is where we can set up additional properties for emulator. What we're going to do is hit new, and in this drop down menu we're going to hit GPU emulation and hit OK. The next thing that we're going to do is under this value tab is change that to yes, because we want to be able to test our games on our emulator, and just hit create AVD, or it'll say edit AVD if you're just editing one of your previous emulators, and that will allow us to test our AndEngine game on our emulator. So that's pretty much it for the setup. We got our AndEngine and our Box2d extension attached to our game, and we have our emulator set up. So all we have left to do is create the actual game, which is going to be awesome. So make sure you guys hit that subscribe button or that like button. We definitely appreciate it. It helps us out quite a bit. So thanks for doing that. And also, just to mention, this tutorial series, we are going to be focusing on very beginner programming stuff. It's mainly going to be focused on the AndEngine library itself. So if you have no idea about programming or anything like that, feel free to try out, you know, this tutorial series. But if you ever get lost, check out like our Java beginner series or basic series, our Android basic series, or even our Java game applet series. You probably want to start out with the Java basic stuff, but just to mention that, it's mainly going to be focused on the AndEngine library. Anyways, thanks guys for watching, and I'll catch you in the next video. See you later.